So now you're putting all this together. You're seeing the beginning of the Second American Revolution. It's underway. It happened with the Tea Parties, the tax protests, the 4th of July demonstrations, the town hall meeting revolts, the people going to march on Washington against big government. Of course, it's being hijacked by different elements out there, but nonetheless, it's still moving forward. So as we're looking at the economy going down, we're looking at the revolution going up, and then we're looking at terrorism. The government knows they're losing control. When they lose control, they tighten the screws. And that's what we're going to see. The screws are going to be tightened in the name of terror.
But how does that play out? Reading your trends forecaster, which I really respect, you're believing it's not going to work. It'll take a few years, but by them showing their hand, that this is the beginning of the end of this group of corporate criminals?
That's the way we look at it now. However, if the wild card goes as wild as starting a war with Iran, then all bets are off because they will keep us in the state of perpetual war. Look, they're keeping us in war now, even though we're in Iraq are bogus. We were told there were weapons of mass destruction. We were told there were ties to Al-Qaeda, and they weren't there. We're still there. So if there's a real war with Iran, a major war, then our forecast changes. And again, we can't predict the wild cards.
And again, they just put out a new fake report saying Iran had nukes. That's now been proven to be fraudulent. They're trying the same playbook. Gerald, I want to go to calls here, but I wanted to ask you this question. I'm sure you saw the Bloomberg article a few weeks ago where Goldman Sachs is arming its employees against the citizens and expect lynch mobs, literally the villagers with pitchforks, to come. Again, they're criminals that have committed these crimes. They can't believe that we're putting up with it. They know they're criminal. They know they've been bad. Can you speak to that?
Well, listen to Lloyd Blankfein, the head of the Goldman Sachs gang. He has the nerve to say he's doing God's work. I mean, you know, these people are delusional in a lot of ways. Yeah, they know the people are after them. One of the trends we wrote about a year ago, it was off with their heads. We saw this coming. Yeah, they know they're in trouble. And so is, by the way, the whole government is in trouble. They're so disconnected. And of course they're disconnected.
Exactly. Even the Democrats on the grassroots, even the chairman of the party, is against this health care bill that raises your taxes and cuts your benefits for the insurance companies who wrote it. The Democrats have now read it, and they don't care if Republicans and Democrats don't want it. Some polls as high as 75% against. They're still going to pass it.
And they did the same thing with TARP. They do the same thing with everything. They cannot gauge the anger of the people because they are living privileged lives. Off with their heads came about because of the same reason. Let them eat cake. Give them a health insurance policy. It's the same thing. They don't have a clue of the anger.
I agree with you, Gerald, and I want to take a few calls here, but let me ask you this. They have the fake neocon they have hijacked the rebellion. But if they ride the peaceful third party into a rat hole, that will only make it explode even bigger the next year.
It may not happen because of again, there's so many wild cards. What if we don't have net neutrality anymore? Then our forecasts are off. And by the way, Australia is now trying to pass legislation that will put them in the same league as China. So
they say that. They say it's Chinese style. That's their quote. Gerald, I'm skipping this break for stations. It's a network break, so we can skip it. I want to talk to Andrea, Frank, Wayne, Josh, and Joe. Guys, have your quick questions ready. But I want to ask you, any other quick trends for 2010 and forward you want to drop on us, Gerald Celente?
Survivalism. And it's not going to the hills with AK-47s or cans of pork and beans. It's at every level. Be prepared for the worst. You always could pull back from it. I'm most concerned about Terror 2010, the prospects of calling control going on. It made them feel as though they lived in the most democratic society in the world. compared to what they saw in Pittsburgh. This is coming from a Russian. So that's how bad it is over here.
Yeah, they're testing our police. They had cops looking for people outside during the day.
Your movies are terrific. I get terrific comments from them. I encourage everybody to watch them. And you're doing what few people do, and I applaud you for the brave stand you take. And I also want to mention, we know how difficult it is out there for everyone. And what we're doing, there's a discount request button. We try to make the Trends Journal available to everybody at any price they could afford. So please let us know. And Alex, keep up the great work. You know, the feedback that we're getting from your CDs, the Obama deception and the fall of the Republic, day after day we get them thanking you and thanking me and thanking all of those that participated on it for doing our part and giving people the courage to also step forward and to do their part, because that's the only way it's going to change.
Well, I think there's no doubt at the end of the day, we're in a fight for our liberties, a fight for our freedoms. There's a global corporate takeover taking place. It uses all these boogeymen to get us to acquiesce to tyranny. But thanks to you and many others telling the truth, there is an awakening happening. And I think time and history and the truth is on our side, Gerald Celente. I think in the end, we're going to beat these people.
We either beat them or we go under, and I'm not for going under. So I say, let's win.
Gerald, thank you so much for talking to us. We'll talk to you next year, my friend.
All right, happy New Year.
You too. There goes Gerald Celente. We have our special guest coming up in the next segment, in the next hour, fourth and final hour, straight ahead, right here on the one, the only, GCN Radio Network. Stay with us.